まずさ、マリオはどのくらいみんなの国でプレイされてるの？
I think everyone knows about Mario.
Unless you had somebody else with the game, or you were a rich little brat, you could not collect all the Pokemon. So it forces you to socialize and talk with people.
It's such a Japanese game. I don't know how to describe it.
We're going to play it. こんにちは、全人類と友達になるとこも、くがみさんです。
モランです。
What?
最初のズームで映りたいからみんな
Yes, that's why we all wanted to be part of Anna's face.
アナしかアップしないけどね。
I just got covered in face.
I know, we're like, my dog! that's what that joke was, and that's why we're laughing.
今日のテーマは、プレン海外で人気な日本のゲームについて
Aaron's video.
今日は、まあ、アーロンが喋る、そういう企画になっております。
What? Oh. Isn't that every video though?
Yeah, what the hell?
You're supposed to talk in every video.
僕ら結構アニメオタク、アニメについての動画いっぱい作るじゃん。ね。バイロンも、アラも僕も、ポールもアニメ大好き。でも、アーロンはアニメは見ませんと。
はい。
何のオタクなんですか？ゲームなんです。
ああ、そうですね。そうですね。
アーロンとバイロンはずっとゲームの話してるよね。
そう。
Oh yeah. We play too. We play games sometimes.
Yeah.
Apex?
Yeah.
Apex
Legends. Apex 知らんかった。なんか寂しい。
You play Apex?
ああ、やったことないです。
That's why. We wouldn't invite you if you played games with us.
なんかだってバイロン、なんかめっちゃすごいゲームがある。
It's like military grade.
Hey, I'm very clumsy, okay? I have a Bukiyo no Tokoro, okay?
これもう拳銃入ってるんじゃないか。
That's what he thought that was. He thought this was a kenji.
Cameraman!
Yeah,
Steam Deck! Which is really hard to get. I tried getting this in Akiba too, but they're usually all sold out.
Nice.
Yeah, beautiful. Steam Deck.
Ana の顔より big. これがもうパソコンのゲームとかができるのね。てかパソコンが中に入ってるのね。
そうだね。
Yeah.
こんな感じで二人はすごいゲーム好きなんで、ゲームといえば日本、やっぱり任天堂もあるし、めちゃくちゃ人気だよねということで、海外で人気な日本のゲームを何個かピックアップして、なんでそれが海外の目線から見て人気なんですよっていうのをね、教えてもらいたいと思います。それでは行ってみましょう。1個目、
はい、
スーパーマリオブラザーズ。
Yes.
Like the OG one, or just like in general, like all the Mario games?
The franchise?
Oh, the franchise.
何言ってるんか。フランチャイズ。
Super Mario Brothers is the first game, no?
マリオシリーズいっぱいあると思うけど、最初のファミリーコンピューターで出たスーパーマリオブラザーズだけじゃなくて、マリオシリーズ、ちょっと全体的に喋っていこうか。動画撮る前で、まあ、みんなでね、考えたなんで人気なのかっていう理由。家族で楽しめるゲーム。
That is true, that is true. I mean, you got kart, you got party, you got golf, tennis, all the sports,
right?
Oh, yeah,
all the sports, yeah.
All four player games, right? If you are a family with like one brother or one sister, it's perfect. If you have more than two kids, good luck, player five. Well, not nowadays, but you know, back then. Is that how they controlled birth rates?
Only four people at a time.
Yeah, only four people at a time. Is that how they did?
Me and my, I have three other sisters.
Oh.
Family, you know, family of six.
Can't play Mario.
ちなみにマリオは全部のシリーズの売り上げが世界で一番らしくて、5億6000万本以上。
わお。
アメリカ人口より多いとなってます。まずさ、マリオはどのくらいみんなの国でプレイされてるの？
I feel like playing and knowing are two different things, right? But, okay, I think everyone knows about Mario.
あ、そうなん？
Everyone knows about Mario.
すごいね。
The character itself is just a recognizable mascot. It's Nintendo's mascot, for God's sake.
Yeah.
Like, Mickey Mouse is to Disney as Mario is to Nintendo.
Right. Slash video games in general.
Yes.
I think.
In Romania also, everyone knows the existence of Mario. It was,
after the communism was done.
Oh, nice.
And we were able to, like, actually, you knew some games.
Oh, I see.
We had, like, the old, I think it was the oldest console, you know, the one that has the cassette and you have to, before you
yeah,
put
yeah,
it
yeah.
in. To work.
So the 世界共通.
Yes, that's definitely that's the only way you can work.
And you'd play like the oldest Mario game, you know, the one where at the end you jump and you go around the flag.
Yeah.
And I always had to play Luigi because I have older brother.
Ah, you were player two, huh?
I was always player two. And if it was my brother, it was my cousin, so.
すごいなって思うのは。 世界中で知られてるキャラクターってあんまり多くなくない。ミッキーは知られてるじゃん。
ミッキーマウス。I feel like number two would probably Mario.
ね、
yeah.
でピカチュウとかじゃないもう。
Yeah, right.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
他にいる？でもなんかその日本関係なく知られてる。
Harry Potter.
ハリー・ポッターの違う。マスコットというか。
Maybe Sonic.
セガ。
だってトムとジェリーとかよりは多分マリオの方が人気。
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
知られてる。
For sure, for sure.
すごいよね、そう考えたら。
Yeah, yeah.
世界で本当2番目、3番目くらい人気な知られてるキャラクターじゃない。
Mario is designed for the beginner gamer, right? With every single game that they have, anybody can pick up a controller and then they can easily understand the salsa.That's it. It's like you don't have to do anything other than to like find out the game like on your own by pressing buttons.
Right.
In
right.
a lot of other games, there's these really complicated tutorials that tell you exactly what to do, but that kind of takes away from your immersion of the game. Right.
Right.
Like, for example, like in Super Mario RPG or like Paper Mario, like those are JRPGs designed for a beginner player.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And so me, at 6 years old, like, not knowing how to play Final Fantasy, I just found Paper Mario, and like, I'm like, oh, this is really cool, it's really engaging, really easy, and like, the interface, the UI in that game is
so easy
for me to understand, right? And so Mario is probably everyone's gateway drug into the gaming community.
It's just a simple game, right? It's like, it's not... So I think a lot of time when you think of like, gachi gachi gamer, you may think of like, Metal Gear Solid, or like...
So, Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah, or like shooting, and like really violent stuff,
right.
Or it's like really nerdy, like... RPGs where you equip like, oh, this sword has a plus 10 strength bonus, so I'm going to equip this instead of this knife, which, you know, has a bleed modifier on it. But it's like, that doesn't mean anything to a lot of people, right?
Correct.
But I feel like if you look at, you know, the very first Mario game, it's you can only go two directions, right? It's like this way or that way, or you can jump, right? And like, isn't it sometimes that the screen will move, so you have to
move?
Yeah. So you have to like, you have to go this way, right? It basically forces you, okay, go that way kind of thing, right?
Yeah, you can't go back because they didn't have the money to support that.
Yeah.
なんかすごいなって思うのがさ、あの RPG とかはどんどんレベルアップしていくじゃん。
Yeah.
だから友達と一緒に1週間やった後に一緒にやろうって絶対ならないじゃん。
Right.
なんかどういう操作か分かんないしと。
Yeah.
でもマリオってさ、半分クリアしてて途中から友達と一緒にできるくなる。
Right.
レベルアップとかもないし、操作方法も簡単だしっていうので、ゲームの神様みたいな感じなの。
Right.
I mean, that's the foundation of what Mario was. I mean, his original aim was Jumpman, after all. Right? And wasn't that just to...ease people into like, oh, this is the guy that jumps. His name is Jumpman. Before he turned into Mario. Yeah.
Yeah, that was like the whole Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong のゲームに出てきたのか。1本目は、スーパーマリオシリーズでした。ちなみに、世界で一番売り上げたゲームランキングがあるんだけど、マリオカート8。これが第6位になってます。
おー、や
ー。
すごい。次、ポケモンシリーズ。
Oh, man. Taking over my life for like,
oh, yeah.
my whole life.
Pokemon が海外で人気な理由は可愛いキャラを戦わせるから。
Yeah.
I
guess so. But it's also like, I think the idea is like, you're raising a team, you know, you're leveling them up, and like, you obviously, like, just like most families, a favorite child, and it's a least favorite child, and so you raise the favorite child up to level 100, and then the rest are level 0 or whatever it is.And it's very reflective of your own personal family dynamic.
Exactly. It teaches you how to be a parent. So then the kids that you don't want, you just stick them in the PC forever for them to rot.
Exactly.
And you never take care of them again.
Yeah.
Unless you release them to an orphanage.
I thought Tamagotchi does that.
Oh, that's
that
true.
Too,
I just don't feed them with them.
Yeah, he's...
子供の時はみんなポケモン日本人はやってんのよ。もう。
Yeah, okay.
みんなやってた。
Uh-huh.
どう?そっちは。
I think most people did, yeah.
If you didn't do it, you were a loser.
Loser!
Yeah. Hey, you don't have Pokemon, you don't have a Game Boy, loser!
You got bullied.
そう、やっぱじゃあ日本と同じくらい人気だったね。
Yeah.
Everyone had the card game, everyone had the game, everyone watched the show, too.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was all part of the same universe, yeah. You had
there you go.
Yeah. When Pokemon Go came out, everyone freaked out. It's like, I get to be Ash Ketchum or whatever, I can be Red.
It was a whole thing, like, people would get lost and stuff because they would play and want to get the specific character. And people crying on Reddit because there's certain Pokemons that you can find only in Japan.
Yeah.
The thing is, like...
You can come here, then. So, if Pokemon Go can only come to Japan, then you can make a lot of tourists.
I mean, it goes back to when Pokemon Red and Blue first came out, right? Like, their marketing strategy was so genius that you could not collect all the Pokemon unless you had friends. Unless you had somebody else with the game, or you were a rich little brat, you could not collect all the Pokemon. So it forces you to socialize and talk with people.
Yeah.
Hey, can I trade my blue exclusive for your red exclusive so we both can complete the Pokedex together? And that has translated to every single Pokemon game, and now even Pokemon Go, right? Where there are only region variants in certain areas in the world, like Japan. You only can get Kamunegi inside of Japan. You only can get Tauros inside of the States. Right? And so that's translated where everybody wants to travel the world to complete the Pokedex in Pokemon Go now.
Mm.
Right? So that's how revolutionary Pokemon was. Like, you can't do it without your team of Pokemon and your friends.
Yeah, the power of friendship.
The power of friendship, yes. They've marketed the power of friendship.
Right, yeah. The other thing you're saying, Byron, is like, if say you want to buy Pokemon, but you can obviously, most people one by one, right? So you rope your friend into buying the other one, so Nintendo makes two sales at the same time.
That's so true! Maybe is that how they did it?
Yeah.
Is that how they did it? That's how they did it. That's how they did it. They doubled their sales.
Yeah.
最初の、あの、ゲームボーイで出たポケモンって、日本って赤と緑なんで、海外は
Red and Blue.
Red and Blue, yeah.
なんでなん
Well, I don't know, you guys have Venusaur and we had Blastoise, okay? That's it.
で、あと、黄色もあるね、一応。
Yeah.
That was cool.
I followed you around, right?
Oh man, I felt like Ash in that one for sure.
Yeah, that was
talking to my Pikachu, man.
あの、Wikipedia によると、ポケットモンスターの赤、緑、青、ピカチュウの合計が今までのゲームのシリーズの中で12番目。
What? It's still number 12?
So, 4600万本.
That's crazy.
Exactly, that's why you were a loser if you didn't have it.
Yeah.
あとすごいのがさ、まあ、ポケモンってゲームも面白いけど、メディアミックス戦略やってて、まあ、アニメも同時に出して、ゲームも出してっていうことしてたから、みんなすごい、のめり込んだよね。
Mm-hmm.
No, they're geniuses. You know what this company did? You know how Ash graduated from being the Shujinko from the series?
Uh-huh.
So, right when he graduated, the first take, the thing that we react to all the time,
uh-huh.
They got the original singer of the original series to sing the, like, the day right after
he became
the champion. And I'm like, you're good. You guys are good, of course!
Well done. Well
right
done.
When we're in the feels about Ash, like, not being the main character anymore, they get the singer to sing the theme song one more time.
Oh,
and the viewership on that video, oh man,
hey.
Yep. Pokemon marketing strategy.
Yeah. Oh,
hit you with nostalgia.
Yes.
ゲームの内容的にはなんでアメリカとかで人気なの?
That's the thing. So, when you have monsters that can fight, it's very revolutionary in the way that you can name your friends and then, what's it called, fight these terrifying gym leaders and have a chance that all of like your friends could like faint and then you could lose, right? And it's just, it builds so much drama inside of the game for a 6-year-old to comprehend, right? You know, Digimon, like those monsters fight, and in Tamagotchi there were some versions where you could fight the monsters, but I don't think that it was to the extent of how interesting Pokemon made it, right?
Mm-hmm.
With their, because with Digimon, they have attacks, right? But then in Pokemon, they have triangles, like different triangles, like water beats fire, grass beats water kind of thing. And they have like this system with a bunch of different like ailments combined in as well, like poison, paralysis, and things like that. They also have like these different stats that nobody seemed to care about until Emerald version. right? And okay. So the world just kept on getting more complicated as time went on. And, you know, the more that you researched into Pokemon, the more that you got into it, right?
It's really fun to, like, make a team of Pokemon, of six Pokemon, that can be effective in, like, any situation. So it doesn't matter, like, who you're up against. Like, oh, I'll throw this Pokemon if the Pokemon is that kind of thing, right? So, like, there's a big element of strategy.
Correct.
To it. And I think that's just kind of fun, right?
Yeah.
Like, most of the Pokemon, they start really cute, right? But then they evolve into be cool looking.
I mean, yeah.
So, like, Charmander is, like, this little lizard, and it's, like, whatever. But then Charizard, oh, yeah, buddy. I mean,
beast.
He's sick. It looks really, really cool and badass, right? And, like, I mean, when I was a kid, I always, like, you know, had this idea, like, you know, having Charizard would be so dope, right? You could, like, fly on Charizard and, like, go to school and have Charizard there with you all the time. It'd be sick, right? And so, like, I think that idea, knowing that, like, kind of, like, what, Charizard, your Pokemon, are, like, with you to the very end. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter what happens. They're your bros.
Yeah.
They stick with you to the end.
なんか、日本人は、その、ポケモン集めるとか、かわいいとかっていうのが、結構やりたいなって。だからでも話聞いてたら、アメリカとかは戦いたいみたいな方が、
oh, that's right, that's right. Like,
強い気がするよね。
As a kid, I would show off my level 100 Pokemon that I made with my Game Shark. It's like, oh, I trained these all myself. Yeah, look how strong my Mewtwo is, or look how strong my Charizard is.
前に出した動画で、まあバイロンと撮ったんだけど、日本のアニメのオープニングが海外では変更されてるっていう動画を撮ったんだよ。
Mm-hmm.
日本のポケモンのオープニングはみんな頑張っていこうぜって感じなんだけど、アメリカのやつは、
oh, I wanna be the very best
level one ever was, get all my Pokemon to level 100!
なんかもうすげえファイトやみたいな感じのオープニングだったよね。
You wanna have the strongest Pokemon ever. You wanna have a team of six Gengars, all no hypnosis, all no dream eater. That was the best strategy for red and blue.
You know, it's funny because, like, I actually didn't know that many people who actually caught all the Pokemon, probably because they just cared about getting the strongest ones and being the Elite Four. Even though, like, the whole point of Pokemon is to catch everything, to catch them all, right? No one actually catches them all.
Yeah.
Which I find kind of funny. It's like, let's just get the best six and just go on, get on with it.
Yeah. Get the best six. It's like, if a Pokemon comes up and I don't like it, I'm not going to catch it, right? Like, I had no idea about Gyarados. Right? I didn't know Gyarados existed. I'm like, whoa, what is this cool blue dragon thing? How do you get that? And then I see Magikarp, I'm like, stupid little fish. Koi Kingu. Stupid little fish. And then my friend told me, no, if you get your Koi Kingu to level 20, it becomes that. What the heck? No, it doesn't!
あとさ、可愛いキャラが日本っぽいよね。可愛くてみんな子供とかも好きになりやすいみたいなのも人気な理由の一つなんかね。ということでポケモンでした。次ダークソウル。
Oh,
oh, Aaron's, oh,
yes.
Aaron's
Dark Souls. Oh, yeah, I love it.
Dark Souls が海外で人気な理由は本物の RPG だから。
そう。
そうです
ね。
いや、これ本当にプレイしたことないから、全然わかんないんだけど、多分 Dark Souls って日本国内より海外の方が人気なんじゃないかな。
Yeah, most likely.
そう、だから見てる人も、まあ、僕も知らないと思う、結構。
Huh. Yeah, which is weird, right? Because the maker of Dark Souls, From Software, is a Japanese company, right?
That's right.
But I think maybe the reason why it got so much traction overseas is because, yes, it's a Japanese maker, but the world itself is like European medieval dark fantasy kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I think a lot of Westerners would look at this and be like, oh, castles, dragons, oh, knights and armor, that sounds cool, and sign me up kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So Dark Souls is basically, you're set in this kind of dark medieval fantasy world. It looks like old Europe kind of thing. With like big castles and churches and stuff.
Yubiwa Monogatari とか.
Yeah. I think it takes a lot of inspiration from that. So, but you traverse through this world and you go through these really, really menacing dungeons, really scary castles, and you fight these big, like, big knights and big monsters and stuff like that. And it's a really, really difficult game. I think part of the reason why it got so popular is because everyone said, like, it's a hard game. It'll kick your ass. It's hard. Beware. It's hard kind of thing. And I think the tagline, the slogan was, prepare to die.
Yeah.
Because it's so hard.
Because if you look at the landscape of how games were back then, like a lot of them were too easy, right? Like you had a bunch of lives. Like there were a bunch of, for Nintendo games, you could do the 1-up hack where you just get like 99 1-ups and you never die, right? And a lot of games like had tutorials where they would literally hold your hand, right? And not be too hard, and you wouldn't get punished for dying too much. And then Dark Souls like totally changed the landscape of games by creating a difficult game.
Right.
Again, because, you know, like in back in the like arcade games, right? Like Pac-Man, Centipede, Galaga, those were hard games and you died like almost instantaneously. And it would just be like these quarter... Like, there's these quarter chuggers, or, I don't know, 100 yen chuggers that would just eat your money up, and that it was designed for you to keep playing, right? And I think that when Dark Souls came in, they kind of took that, but then they made it into a household name
to
be, like, a hard video game.
Right? Yeah, because, like, not even just arcades, but, like, say in, you know, Super Ghouls and Ghosts. And
yes!
Like,
yes!
There's no save system, right? So... There's like, I don't know, there's been like 12 levels or something like that in Super Ghouls and Ghosts. So if you make yourself all the way, get to the 12th level and you die, you have to start right at the beginning. And that's like a really, really, like, it's so annoying. But then like, it kind of motivates you. It's like, you learn from your mistakes and you try again and you'll inevitably make another mistake, right?
Correct.
But then you just keep learning and learning and learning, right? And it's the same thing with this.
Yeah, no way. 今までさ話してたのはキャラクターがとか、
yeah.
誰でもできるとかだけど、
yeah.
全く可愛くなくて、でめちゃくちゃ難しいゲームって、ゲーム好きな人に刺さるように作られたゲームってことね。
Yeah, right.
でもなんかそれでもやり込んでめちゃくちゃ難しくて一つのことを極めるみたいなのって逆にそこも日本っぽいなってちょっと思う。
Like, I feel like a Western company couldn't make this game. I don't think it'd be possible because, like, it's such a Japanese game. I don't know how to describe it. Gaman しかない
Gaman しかない
やるしかないみたいな感じ。The atmosphere and, like, the items and the magic and the different weapons and stuff like that is very Western, right? But I think that the gameplay, the 難しさ, the 我慢しないといけない, whatever, is, like, very...Japanese. I think a lot of people saw, like, that was like a perfect blend between the two.
Ah, そういうことか.
Because if it was completely Western, you'd still have those Western environments and stuff like that, but you wouldn't have this hard bit. It would be too easy, or it'd be too, like, flashy, like, kakkoi. You know what I mean? This is, like, hard and, like, really gritty and just, like, intense and just, like, bleh.But it's not like a cowboy game where you're really slick and you're like, you know.
なるほどね。
Right? Yeah.
もうカッコつけてるとかそんなんじゃなくて本物のゲームなんだ。
Yeah.
本物の強さなんだ。
Yeah. It's an experience. It's a true experience of, it's a test of the human will, you know.
Yeah, you're right.
あっつ。あっつこの部屋。
The name Dark Souls has just been synonymous with hard or difficult.
Yeah.
Dark Souls equals hard, right? So if you say...Oh, this is like Dark Souls. It's just like, okay, this must be difficult then. It's kind of...
Right. Like, I have Hogwarts Legacy, right? The Harry Potter game. And then, you know, if I put it on hard mode, I die in 2 hits to even like the smallest mob. And I'm like, oh, this is basically Hogwarts Dark Souls.
Yeah. And the other thing about Dark Souls, there's no difficulty setting. It's just... default hard.
Imagine
it. You can't change it.
Yeah, exactly.
Like it's meant to be hard. But like the thing is, it's like a very strict parent, like a strict teacher. You know, you make a mistake, smack on the head. Make a mistake, smack on the head. You do it right, you can go ahead. You know, you did it right. So.
Dark Soul でした。次。
はい。
でね。動物の森。
ああ。
はい。で人気な理由は。超リラックスできるゲーム。ダークソウルの後に来たらもうそのギャップがすごいね。
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. So, Animal Crossing, it's also a game where everybody can just pick it up, right? You don't even need to figure out the movement because there's no levels to it. It's just, you know, you go on an island, you pick fruit, do chores, and owe money to a random tanuki guy. Right? Like, there's no stress in that. It's like, you use Dobutsu no Mori the same way that you would use...a meditation app on your phone.
Meditation?
Yeah, you just sit on the couch And like you relax, you shut off, and then, you know, if there's dishes in the sink, you don't do them, but you will pick up the weeds off on your virtual island. You'll do that.
ちょっと僕さ、動物の森やったことないからわかんないんだけど、レベルアップありません。
No.
敵もいませんってこと?
Well, here's the thing. You are sent to a random island with nothing on it except fruit trees, right? And then you're, this tanuki guy gives you a tent, right? And then he tells you, hey, I gave you a tent, but by the way, you owe me money. Oh, you don't have money? You can do odd jobs for me. Start picking weeds off the island, right? And then you just search around, like you can fish, you can catch bugs, you can do anything to sell it for bells, which is the in-game currency, and then you pay him off, and then he's like, oh, you paid me off, I'm gonna upgrade your house. And it's just this ongoing thing where you just try to upgrade your house as much as you can, and that's it.
でもゲームオーバーとかない?
No. No.
やってて、ギリギリそこのボーダーをクリアできるかどうかわからなくて、できた時に、よっしゃ!よっしゃ!勝った!ボスに勝った!っていうのがさ、アドレナリン出てるのが、ゲームの楽しさみたいな。
Ah, but Animal Crossing does have that, 意外に。
ある。
They have it because of a thing that most gamers like to call and is called RNG. Random Number Generator. So in the Safari Zone, Raki, right? One of the rarest Pokemon inside of the Safari Zone. You can't get that unless you're really, really lucky due to a thing called Random Number Generator, RNG. And if all the planets align, you can get to catch that Pokemon, right? But the catching of that Pokemon is so slim. Like, you know when your Pokemon moves like this? And whether it gets you catch it or not, it's all based on RNG, right?
今動物の森の確率を説明するためにポケモンを使ってる。
Well, yeah, because I can't explain it to you in 動物の森 terms. I'm going to explain it to you in the game that you understand. So, inside of 動物の森, there are several fish that you can catch, right? And there are fish that only have a 1.01% chance of appearing, right? And so, like, you only know the fish from the shadow.Right? And then if you look up the encyclopedia, it's like, oh, these fish are categorized as these big shadows. So like, it's only available in these shadows. And these tiny, tiny fish are categorized as these shadows. So please look out for these shadows. And then within that category, one fish has a 0.01% chance of appearing. And when you get that fish finally, yeah! That's the adrenaline in Animal Crossing.
レアな魚が取れた時が一番アドレナリンが出るってこと?
Yes!
どんなゲーム?
Yes! It's yeah! You collect all the fish, collect all the bugs, and then design your house. That's what Animal Crossing is. Yes.
そっか。
I mean, the thing is, like, it got better over time. It didn't used to be a game where, like, you could really interact with your friends as much inside of the game. I mean, they did have...On the GameCube, you could put, like, the memory card in, and you could visit your friend's island. But now, because we have the internet and we have the technology, you can visit each other on islands. And, that's why we got so popular, because of Corona. Yeah. When Corona happened, nobody could go outside. So what did they do? They played Animal Crossing, and then they talked to their friends through Animal Crossing. Right?
Yeah. Animal Crossing is the game that kept friendship intact through the pandemic.
Yes. True, yeah. I would, yeah, that's very true.
なんかリラックスするためにゲームするって新しいよね、なんか。
Right, yeah. Because, like...You know, you have a stressful day at work. The last thing you want to do is play Dark Souls, you know?
ちなみに、集まれ動物の森スイッチで出たゲームは、スイッチのゲームの中で2番目に売り上げてる本数が多くて、マリオカート8が、まあ、Wii U とスイッチで出て、それが6900万本。で、その次がスイッチで出たあのゲームね、4479万本。
Wow. Oh my gosh.
すごい、意外じゃない?スマブラより高い。
Well, that's the thing. Not everybody can play Smash Bros.
That's true.
Not everybody doesn't get a kick out of just like dying if they don't know how to recover. Right? Like, oh, B up. What do you mean? B and then up or B at the same time, right? And you have to teach that to people.
And I feel like Smash Bros is most fun when you have friends with you.
ああ、なるほどね。
Right? But like, 動物の森 you can play on your own, right?
ああ、女の子とかもやってるもんね、いっぱいね。
Yes, yes.
動物の森でした。イェーイ次スマッシュブラザーズ。
ああ、
やっす。スマブラが海外で人気な理由はみんなで集まって 対戦できるということで。
Yes.
He bought one for the office. He bought a Switch and Smash.
Yes.
そうです。
We're still unlocking characters.
And he hates losing.
That's true. That's true. He does.
ゲームやるときは本気や。
We should have a live where like, fans challenge us in the tournament.
That'd be fun.
Oh my god, that'd be so fun.
Yeah,
yeah,
we should
yeah.
do it.
The Smash Brothers was the funnest thing to do in the international dorm that I lived in.
Yeah.
I never owned a Switch, but I played so much Smash Brothers because we would always have tournaments and would make like special tournaments too. We did one when we would play only Ganondorf tournaments.
Only Ganondorf?
And
Ganon.
Because those who play know this, but with Ganondorf you can do the side B where it just goes down, right? And if
yeah.
you do it while you're in the air with someone, you're just gonna put him all the way down
oh,
and
yeah,
die
yeah,
together.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And it's like you're gonna die first if you do that, right? But
yeah, but yeah, you
got
to hit him
but
first,
like,
right?
Yeah. Like we all know who actually won when that happens.
Like, Smash Brothers is a game where like you have to play every single character to be good at the game.
Yeah.
Like as a Ganon player, I know people are gonna do well. It doesn't help if they're in it. they're,
yeah.
Everybody's Ganon, but like if you're facing a Ganon, like they're gonna bait you there. So all I do is just go up and oh, I just try to fake them out because like I know what you're fucking going
right,
to do,
right.
And they eventually just like kill themselves.
Right? 一応ね、スマブラ知らない方のために説明しておくと、スマッシュブラザーズはみんなで対戦するゲームだよね、基本。まあ一人とか二人ももちろんできるけど、四人とか集まってやるゲームで、今まで出てきた任天堂のキャラクターがもうほぼ出てくるんじゃないかくらい使って対戦できるよね。
Yeah,
that's
crazy.
The best.
Like, you know, there's lots of other fighting games like Tekken and what else is there? That's all I can think of.
Street Fighter,
so, Tekken, Street Fighter, and like, they have like what? A good amount of characters, right? But Smash Bros. Has like, how many characters does it have?
So,
now the roster is huge.
So, すごいのが、任天堂が作ってるから、任天堂のキャラクターが出る。
Yeah.
そうだけじゃないんだよね。
Nope.
いろんなゲームの会社とコラボして、メタルギアソリッドのスネークとか、ファイナルファンタジーのクラウドとか、
yeah.
セフィロスとか。
Pac-Man's in it.
Oh, yeah.
Rockman.
Oh,
Rockman is also in it. Mega Man.
Oh, that's a Nintendo thing.
みたいな感じで、もう何でもありの夢のゲームになってるわけよね。みんなで集まって4人とかでゲームするって、海外ではあんまりなかったの。
I guess not. I mean, like, the very first Smash Bros. Was the N64 one, right? And like, I guess GoldenEye, James Bond, GoldenEye came out
yeah.
around the same time. And like, stuff like that, you could all play together, but it was split screen, right? The screen would be split up.
Mm-hmm.
And you had this tiny box, right? It was kind of hard to see, but Smash was just one big screen, right? So it kind of felt a bit more like, you know, you're all playing on
inclusive,
the same.
Inclusive,
yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. It felt more of a group activity than like, you know.
Tiny little box that I can screen look my friend
exactly,
and know where
yeah.
he is on the map
yeah.
and then shoot.
Stop screen peeking.
I can see it too.
Yeah,
I'm
yeah,
just like, my eyes don't like go focus on one area
yeah,
only.
Exactly,
okay?
Yeah.
I'm six. Like, what am I going to do?
Yeah.
Respect you?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I mean, Smash Bros. It's the thing is that we all play Nintendo games, and because of the Japanese way of making video games, hit you right in the kokoro. You know,
kokoro.
It's like you have Zelda, Mario, Kirby, all these games that have like a very vast storyline to them that kind of make you really invested into the characters. That's why it's done so well as a game, right? And that's why you have these things like release trailers for the game, like, and they've done loads with their marketing
with
that, and that's why there's these reactions on YouTube where people are freaking out to the release of new characters because you know Smash Brothers is just such a revolutionary game. Like as Aaron was saying, there's fighting games, and you know PlayStation tried to make PlayStation All Stars, getting all of the like PlayStation characters together to fight in the same way that they would do in Smash Brothers, but it hasn't been done in the way that Nintendo has done it,
no.
right? Like, there is no better enjoyment from someone seeing their favorite Final Fantasy character get put in a Nintendo game, you know?
Yeah.
That was crazy.
興奮したよね、
先生。Yeah, that was crazy.
丸のやつがプシンって割れて、
yeah.
うーってなった。
Zooms in the cloud.
Yeah.
Dude, that's amazing, right? And it's not only just the released characters that are in the game, right? Through assist trophies, they put other other video games that haven't made it into the character roster in, so they can still have their appearance and also like the theme music from very really popular games. Mm-hmm. So imagine fighting in a Star Fox like arena with Pokemon music, with Mario and Cloud and Sonic and Pac-Man in the same area to music from Undertale.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, like,
what is the situation? Yeah.
How do all of these things combine into one game? And Smash Brothers, you know, with all of their licensing and their monopolization of the whole market, right, has been able to make such a beautiful product, right?
Yeah.
The ultimate collab.
And the ultimate thing that they've done was getting Disney
what?
To approve of the release of Sora inside of
yeah.
Smash Brothers. That was crazy.
That
How did you get Disney to say, sure? That
yeah.
is the hardest sure to get
I
in
feel
the
like
world.
Disney is the most like tight-lipped about anything, right?
Yes.
Like, they won't allow anything,
so,
right?
How? And they zoomed into the freaking Mickey Mouse thing.
Yeah.
They zoomed into the Mickey Mouse thing.
一応説明しとくと、キングダムハーツっていうゲームがあって、それはスクエアエニックスとディズニーが一緒にコラボレーションして作ってるゲームなの。ディズニーの世界を渡り歩いて、どんどん物語を進めていく RPG になってるんだけど、で、その中にはソラっていう主人公がいて、みんな絶対出ないだろう。あれはもう、いろいろ厳しいからライセンスだと思ってたけど、
うん、
めっちゃ興奮したよね。キーブレードからピーンって光るの。
Oh my
god, that was crazy.
ちょっとね、ファイル止まらないから話少し戻すけど、今までのゲームちょっと見てても、みんなでやるっていうのが日本多いなと思って。海外のゲームって、ネットの中でみんなでやるはあるけど、基本一人でやるのが多くない。ゲームの売上ランキングが Wikipedia に載ってるんだけど、1位がマインクラフト。まあ、マインクラフトはゲームの中ではちょっとやるけど、基本的に自分でやるじゃん。その、ここにさ、集まってみんなでゲームしようぜみたいなのないじゃん。2番がグランドセフトオート。
GTA。
そう。これもさ、みんなでよしやろうっていう感じじゃなくて、それに対して日本のやつは Wii スポーツとか、マリオカートとか、あのポケットモンスター、動物の森とか、みんなで同じ場所にいても遊べるゲームが多い。
Right, right. That's true.
多分考え方の違いだと思うよ、これ。
Japanese games have made it simple to do that, right? Because you only need one console, one screen for everybody to get together and play at somebody's house, right? With American games, it's complicated. Everybody has to bring their whole PC to a house to play a four-player game together. And this is only for people who are really, really into games, right?
Yeah.
But then because of Nintendo and other Japanese games' accessibility, as well as like simplicity of the game, it makes it easy for four people to get together, even if they're not gamers, to be marketed to,
right? You know, going back to the N64, it had four controller ports. GameCube, four controller ports. Wii, you can connect like so many different Wii remotes to the thing. You were able to have a lot of people in the same place, right? Because you had all these different options for controllers. So
even when Smash came out, like, I would just go to my friend's house, and then we wouldn't even say that we're gonna play the game, and then we're just sitting on the couch, and then my friend would say, "One," I'm like, "All right, one," and I would just automatically have my controller ready. Right?
Yeah.
So when you wanted to play at someone's house, you'd always bring like your own controller, right?
多分考え方の違いとして、日本はみんなでいることを面白くするためのゲームって感じで、海外は自分が面白くなるためのゲームっていう、なんか大きな違いがあるんかなっていう感じはしたよ。
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
なんかみんなで一緒に友達といるところの全体が楽しくなるか、自分が楽しいかみたいな。
Right, I mean, I remember like when I was a kid in Kobe, I would go to my friend's house and play, Donkey Kong 64.
Mm-hmm.
We'd all get together and play Donkey Kong 64. But when I moved to Canada, I didn't do that as much. Well, of course I would go to my friend's house sometimes play Smash Bros. But like I felt like the times I went to play games with all my friends in Kobe was a lot more frequent than I did back home. It would, you know, by a proportion, I guess.
Yeah, it's interesting. Like, Japanese games have really just brought more people together at houses, right?
Smash Brothers でした。 今日は海外で人気な日本のゲームについて話してみました。日本のゲームと海外のゲームの楽しみ方の違い、例えばダークソウルが海外の方が人気なのは自分が楽しむためだと思う、うん、でも日本でもっと人気があるのはみんながいる場所が楽しくなるゲームだったりとか、であとは可愛いキャラクターが、まあ、すごく多い、違いを知れて面白かったなと思うから、この動画が好評だったら海外のゲームとかについてもねちょっと知りたいなと思いますんで、皆さんがもうおすすめのゲーム、思い出のゲームがあれば、そのストーリーとともにコメント欄まで書いてください。
There's a lot of games that we did not mention、sure, yeah. So maybe we'll do a number two for this.
そうね、いいね。他に僕らにトークしてほしいトピックがあればコメント欄までよろしくお願いします。それでは次の動画でまたお会いしましょう。バイバイ。チャンネル登録をね。
ガイ。
シ。バスー。